I can ask what is the common between Mr. Igor Zorin, mentioned in the previous panel, Tatiana Festling, it's one of the famous persons from Pegida movement, Evgeny Shchegolikhin, Britain First, and Knights Templar International. Among many things between them, all is connected to Bulgaria as training and supporting of some of the groups based here in Bulgaria. You can see the first image. This image is from Bulgaria and part of one of the, how to say, they don't call it this training, but meeting of members of European Solidarity Movement. So this training is provided, and the whole place is provided by one of the movement. It's a Bulgarian organization, Binio Shipka. Shipka is famous place here in Bulgaria, connected to the anti-Ottoman sentiment and the war for independence from Ottoman Empire. So this organization have different faces. One face is for internal usage and another is for external usage. I can say that the movement are mixing different political ideologies, and they have members from different part of the society. So the members of Benio Shipka are not hesitated to not shy to show their links and preferings of Moscow, and they are against NATO and European Union, as other movements in the Slovakia and Czech Republic and Poland. They have a very strong connection to Donbas region and propagated the Russian intervention in Ukraine. Also, they have they make conscripts from people mostly from seaside, I mean city of Varna and city of Burgas, the port cities of Bulgaria, main ports of the country.
Also, Ruslan, your connection seems a bit spotty. Maybe if you turn off your camera, just leave the presentation up, because the sound seems failing. But if you turn off the camera, sometimes the sound improves.
Till when was a good connection? So I repeat that they gathering not only members but also support from exclusively seaside regions of Bulgaria, because partly because of Russian presence in this part of Bulgaria, and also they have connections to the regions surrounding border with Turkey. One of the places famous with this movement are Transnational, which is located on the border with Turkey, and the hut Svezhen, which is unofficially one of the headquarters of trainings. And I can say that during our researches with Kirill Avramov, we found photos and videos and also different proofs of activity from right-wing extremists from different countries, including Austria, Netherlands, Denmark, Finland, UK, and also countries from Eastern part of Europe. I can say it also that Beno are mixing ideologies, including they are described ourselves, we are not nationalists, we are preparing for the end to. I know that this is maybe not sound serious, but the basic of their problem, I think the sound is good, yes, just make a
Yeah. It keeps getting spotty. So
I don't know why. It's very.
It used to be very stable. I think you said Russia too many times.
Maybe sharing, and I think, yeah, maybe. Okay. Let's move with another slide. You can see one of the Danish members of these trainings. I can say Beno is homegrown proto-militia. It's not exactly paramilitary group, but they have symptoms of proto-militia. They have local networks for gathering everything from financing to jackets or including weapons. Also, in their ideology, they are connected to the so-called Ruski Mir. It's a Russian world, and they are not shy of presenting that. As I said before, they are connected of this kind of survivalism, which is famous for US type of groups. And they are promoting very actively, including today, on this COVID situation, they are promoting that with anti-vaxxers and also points connected to this ideology. As I said, they have similarities to the US type militias. They are providing trainings for EU right extremists. And this is very important to say that while they do not recognize the current constitutional order in Bulgaria, the security services in Bulgaria didn't act for so many years against this group, and they are active right now. So we didn't saw any action against them. They have proved links to underworld in Bulgaria, far-right networks across Europe. And it's very interesting, Jerio sales like Igor Zoni mentioned in the Slovakia report before me. They interesting that they received financial help and material from Britain first. I think this is a popular organization for everyone researched far-right. They have also financial help from Knights Templar International. They are connected also to the Syrian regime with links to National Socialist Party in Syria. So we can see the whole network of this organization. We are not here. Why I use it? Because every time when we trying to shed the light of these groups, they pretend they are not exist, or they are not the group presented to me. They have visible links to the Russian security apparatus, not only Igor Zorin, but other Russian citizens living in Bulgaria. It is worth to mention that after our research for Bellingcat, before 2 years, we published one special article on this group. Almost every of public accounts were closed after this publication. So we have a presence of Russian agents on Bulgarian soil, and it was proved many years ago, including during our research. But we have a problem with the Bulgarian government denying that, including today. Providing special training to both volunteers from the Balkans and Western Europeans. I mean, this man, Igor Zorin, was mentioned in many reports from North Korea to Taiwan, to Eastern Europe. And all this network is ruled by the same people who made the camps in Serbia, which I mentioned, I will mention now. And as I said, there is proved links. If someone wants to read more, I will send some of our
Ruslan, for whatever reason, your sound seems to be completely gone now.
Proved links between local mafia circuits.
Okay, now you're back.
Yeah,
now you're back.
As I said,
maybe move on through the presentation fairly quickly so that you can stop sharing.
Yeah,
because okay. That also takes bandwidth. Yeah.
I almost finished it with the Igor Zorint and Beno Shipka. I should say that these camps we are seeing on the I hope this is visible for everyone. Patriotic Cube camps. They are recruiting the so-called next generation Russian world supporters. This is one of the camps closed now, but we have signals that the camp will be reopened in other part of Serbia or possibly in Herzegovina region. And this is this camp Zlatibor is absolutely example for how this network mentioned in Bulgaria is working with local groups, expanding not only on the camps, but ideologically expanding to other countries, and they are using Serbia and also on the next slide, Belarus. So we have this this big network from Balkans to Eastern Europe, and they are operated by the same people. I mean, Zlatibor is organized by the same people organized this. We can see the image from Belarus in western part of the country by same people. I mean, Enot Corporation with some kind of private military group like Wagner, but working mostly on Ukraine and Balkans. According to information, Enot is dissolved, but our information shows that the members of the group are still active. You can see this is one of the images from the camp in Serbia, and this network is working almost the same in different places, which means they are coordinated, and this is not a local phenomenon, but it's interconnected.